وهؤلاء نأتي بكتب السلف، نأتي بالقرآن، نأتي بالسنة، نأتي بكتب البخاري ومسلم وأبو داود والترمذي والنسائي وما ألفه أحمد وما ألفه غيره، نأتي بها. ومن هو على طريق هؤلاء ومن ينابذهم ويخالفهم؟
من الشيخ ساد: فالشاب الذي يتلقف هذه الدعايات وهو خالي الذهن مما يدادها من العلم النافع لا شك أنها ترسخ في ذهنه ويصعب بعد ذلك اجتذابها منه. He said a young person who now be subjected to these false ideologies, if he has no knowledge to push it away, he will fall a victim to it. But if that person, if that young man or that young girl, they grow up in a household, in a house where the Book of Allah is implemented, the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ is well respected and followed, if he goes, even if he sees something, he'll say, "A'udhu billah, that's what my parents warned me against, A'udhu billah, now I'm in a practice time. I'm going to practice that. I'm going to stand firm against these people, against this influence." When that girl smiles at him, he don't smile back. He knows, "A'udhu billah, that's what my mother and my parents warned me against. Allahu Akbar, now I see it with my face, with my eyes." When they're going to come and try to get him to smoke that reefer or that crack or whatever, sniff something, he's going to know, "A'udhu billah, this is what my parents warned me against." When he be in the street, this is in the street, of course. When maybe somebody try to talk to him about something or something that is not from the deen of Islam, he knows these doubtful things. He knows this is not permissible for him to engage in these things. But if he has no knowledge, no knowledge that is beneficial, no education, and their parents didn't do their job, right? It's hard to take out from his heart that which was being installed, from the enemies of Islam. And that's why if the parents, they neglect the education, they think they have children, but they have enemies. Their own enemies, enemies to Islam, enemies to the community, enemies to themselves. Because they cannot even benefit themselves. They're wronging themselves all time, causing themselves trouble, causing their parents trouble, of course, and causing trouble to the community. Because a bad child, nobody can benefit from. If there is a bad young child in the community, everybody will like not comfortable to be around him. Especially those who have young girls. Because they're never gonna feel comfortable bringing their families around the family of that young, foolish, inconsiderate, have no respect, that child that have no respect for nobody else. That's why it is very important for the parents to remember the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he said in Surah Al-Tahrim, يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا وقودها الناس والحجارة عليها ملائكة غلاظ شداد لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. Oh, you who believe, save yourselves and your families. A fire that is its fuel is man and stone, and on it are angels. They severe and strong. They don't disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that which He commanded them with, and they do that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them with.